What we're really trying to do is change the culture of politics, which I think is now much more universally accepted is dysfunctional. When we first started this 3.5 years ago, I don't think it was as apparent as it is now, and certainly in the last election, a sense of frustration and anger with the way politics has worked on both sides of the aisle. But we think that there is a hunger out there for something different, for a new commitment to a politics of reason and common sense, of cooperation and of working together. And, you know, I can't tell you how many people sort of thought the idea of bringing Republicans and Democrats and independents together to talk to Republicans and Democrats and independents was some sort of bizarre idea when we started this a few years ago. Talk about the economy, the jobs issue, the national deficit, and hopefully create a national dialogue on our issues, a constructive, productive national dialogue about how we can commit to moving forward together and how we can commit even when it may mean self-sacrifice. And I think Americans are up for that. It can't just be about self-interest. It also has to be about asking for commitment and what we can all do to make this country better.
We are now just mired in an internecine struggle for authority, when actually that authority will be meaningless without support from the other side. We can afford to have, you know, these competing cable networks and this struggle of ideology and bashing each other and politics, gotcha games and all kinds of investigations of different people. But we can't do it when we're in the economic downturn that we're in right now. And actually, while I think that the answer to our problems is going to have to come from a global resolution, probably the most significant global resolution of finance occurring in 1944, the Bretton Woods Conference. Mm-hmm. If we're going to have a new Bretton Woods, the first thing we're going to have to establish is some cooperation. That in a struggle such as this, we're going to have to work together. We're not going to get anywhere standing around and watching the people in charge fail because they can't get joint consensus. And I think that everyone needs to think about that at this particular point, because the country really needs the type of leadership that we had in the 30s and 40s, when after the recession and working into World War II, when the country did come together. And when we have the tremendous conflict between the two parties that we have right now, where both parties will say it when they're in charge, but neither will when they're in the minority, which is what we're seeing, almost gloating at watching the other party fail, as the Democrats did in 2008, and as Republicans have done in 2009, 2010, we're not going to get anywhere that way. We're going to have to come to some consensus about the shared sacrifices that Patricia was talking about before, that is the only way that we're going to escape from this crisis. So I think the lesson really has a lot to do with the extraordinary, sensible discourse in a civilized manner that the common good brings.